Look like they had a sail under his horns this year. more horns.
All right, it's going to take them.
Thank you.
Silence. Thank you. So there's going to be a 1 minute moment of silence in honor of those who have fallen and those who've contributed so much to this spectacular event, the annual Cup Match Classic. It starts now. And the moment silence has ended.
Sean, this is the time that I tell everybody it's one of the best times of a cup match. Just before the first ball.
That's right.
You've never been to first ball of cup match. That's the time when you really want to get the true essence of what cup match, how we, what it means to people. This is the time because no matter where you come from, east or west, some sort of Georgia's, at this present moment, you think you can win. It doesn't matter what's happened in the last 10 years. Right now, you have the most confidence than anybody else.
That's right.
That you can win a cup match.
That's right.
This is your year.
It doesn't get any better than this. It really doesn't. This is when you are happy. I remember, what was the year? Maybe it's about 3 years ago. St. George's were facing a 10 wicket victory. Dean Hines there. We can still do this.
Yeah.
We can still do this. And that was legendary optimism.
Can't wicket defeat that was.
Yeah, no, defeat, I'm sorry.
Yeah. See what
my
saying.
Name was still there. We can still do this if we do this and we do that. That was the energy like.
I was believing that seeing people fly.
Well,
that's right.
He would. I didn't know what match he was watching.
Short is shaking his head. I think Lorenzo was in the hill shaking his head. But Dean was still trying to go through all his notes.
All he had some analysis out of the sky.
We'd like to say good morning to all the sick and Cheyenne folks who could not get here today. Thank you for tuning in. Want to say good morning to the Woolridge family.
Want to say good morning to Mrs. Woolridge. Pay tribute, as we always do, to the man who paved the way for us to be here, the Honorable C.B. Jim Woolridge, the original Voice of Summer. Pay tribute to him and everything that he did to make this. He set the bar for all of us as commentators. I'm going to go to the next one.
time ever again, everybody. We need to find some groove. Cricket Club 3355. You have a great great concert. 3355. Thank you.
They were trying to find positive. They were
making their way out to the wicket. Very good. You look at the picture earlier. Tell me what you saw. Because I knew I'd been out here all week. So the lot of grass sorted. The frame this morning. Looked a bit dead. There was a little bit more inside of the pitch than looked this morning. Okay, so the pitch has not been played on. Right? So it's only like 2 hours of play on it. So it's a brand new wicket. It's hard. You know, underneath. But it has a lot of grass. So what the bars is actually done this time around.
So it's a brand new wicket. It's hard underneath, but it has a lot of grass. And so what the groundsman has actually done this time around to, you know, to suit the St. George's players, to home team, what he's done is actually, it's quite a bit of grass, but he's basically rolled it in.
Yeah.
So we should, with the conditions the way that it is, you know, you're talking about cards over, we should see a lot of spin, right? We should, well, first of all, we're going to see a lot of movement.
Yes.
First thing in the morning, we should see, I mean, if the bowler goes ahead and gets it right, we should see a lot of movement off the seam. So we're going to see some action for the first 2 hours, I guarantee.
And that's the crazy part of it, because I was here on Saturday for the first ball for the trial match. We didn't have this cloud covering. There wasn't much movement off the seam early. Now we have cloud covering. Humidity is high, and we know with a brand new ball, you should get some movement off the seam. So it'd be a bit different from what people saw Saturday morning, early Saturday morning, compared to now. Sean, we're about to have the first ball. Take it away.
Well, it's going to be Zico Burgess opening the bowling for St. George. Zico Burgess will be bowling to Chris Douglas. He will be bowling with three men in the slips. That's Delray Rollins, Rodney Trott, and Onias Baskin. Sinclair Smith is behind the stumps. There's one man at the point, another man at the covers, a mid-off. Brian Hall is at mid-on. There is a man at silly mid-on. And a man at backward square leg. The umpires request the music to be terminated. And we are ready to go. The 2023 annual Cup Match Classic is about to begin. Live from Wellington Oval. The Zico Burgess about to bowl to the left-hander Chris Douglas. Mr. Carrington, the umpire, is giving the signal from the square leg end, and Stephen Keynes is the umpire on duty. Nervous anticipation all around this ground. Getting everyone in order, everyone in position. And Mr. Keynes gives the signal. The air horns have started. Cup Match 2023 is underway. Zico Burgess is in. Right arm over the wicket to bowl to the left-handed Douglas. He delivers and wide outside the off stump, moving away. And Douglas lets it go through to the wicket keep. Smith, who dives to his left to collect. And the 2023 annual Cup Match Classic is underway. What an atmosphere we have here. Absolutely electric. Burgess back at his mark, turns, waits for Mr. Keynes to give him the go ahead. And he's in again. Right arm over the wicket to the left hand of Douglas. Comes in and delivers. And this one, Douglas pushes through mid-wicket. They hustle through quickly for a single. Is being chased by Brian Hall, who picks it up just in front of the mid-wicket boundary and returns it to the bowler's end. Not before they go through for two. So Chris Douglas is off the mark. He opens his account with two, and Somerset have two. He's in again. Right arm over. Douglas pushes this one down to mid on, and again it's Brian Hall who fields. No addition to the score. No addition to the score. Two without loss. Chris Douglas taking strike from Zico Burgess. And he's in. Right arm over. Burgess bowls to Douglas. Douglas is wrapped on the pad. There's a loud and confident appeal. But it was going down the leg side. Going down the leg side. And here he comes, right arm over the wicket, and bowls to Chris Douglas. And Douglas flashes at that one. Short, and then moved away. And Douglas watched it go by. Zico Burgess bowling with three men in the slips. Four, really, if you include the man at backward gully. And this one pops up in front of Douglas. And there's no run there. The end of the first over. First over, bowl by Chris Douglas. The score is two without loss. Chris Douglas has both of those runs.
Sean, just take a note that wicketkeeper Sinclair Smith has put his helmet on, so he's looking to go up to the stumps.
Yeah, so looks like it's going to be Delray Rollins. The bowling, yes. Delray Rollins will be bowling from directly below our sports microphone.
And I mentioned earlier with the team selection, they decided to go with the extra spinner in this team. So when you look at the likes of Delray, it looked like a Rodney Picnic Trot, Alan Douglas,
Brian Hall,
who has the most wickets in the league this year.
That's right, he's going very well.
So it's going to be quite interesting. A different approach over the last few years from St. George's. Once again, they have to get their 20 wickets, so they need to come back with something different and try something else.
Yep. Yep. I'm sure part of their decision making. Mm-hmm. They need to bowl Somerset out twice if they're going to win this match. Their tactics will be completely different. Delray Rollins, left arm around the wicket, spins this one up to Frey, and Frey is forward defensively, bat and pad together. Rollins bowling with one man in the slip, left arm around, bowls. Frey watches that one go by outside the off stump. It's one man in slips, and then there's a silly mid on. Rollins again. This one, Frey pushes through the covers, goes out to deep extra cover where it's fielded by Douglas, Alan Douglas Jr. And there's one run. So Terran Frey opens his account, and Somerset move on to three. Three without loss. Mm-hmm. This brings up the left-hander, Chris Douglas. Douglas has two. Rollins to Douglas. Douglas, is he? There's a loud appeal as it comes off of his pads, and then it went into. Did someone take that? Catch that?
Zende caught that.
It was a catch, but it came off of his pads. You know, Zende Ferbert at silly mid on. You know, at this stage of the day, everything generates excitement. This one, he turns on the onside.
D, that is Sean's favorite position right there. Is that Nate Ferber?
Silly middle. Rollins again to Douglas. Douglas is forward. It's a loud appeal. This is wrapped on the pad.
And Sean, that's a good tactical move of getting Delray right into the game, right?
Yes.
You know, right from the start.
Yeah.
I mean, that's, that sort of calms your nerves, Don.
Yeah, it does. It does.
Right?
Yeah.
Calms
you. Get him into it right away. Yeah.
And that's the end of the over. So it was one run in that over from Delray Rollins. So Zico Burgess has bowled one over, no mains, and he gave up two runs. Delray Rollins bowled one over, and he gave up one run in that over. So the third over will be bowled by Zico Burgess. Zico Burgess bowling with two men in the slips. Then there's a wide third man. Then there's a short, fine leg. He comes in and Frey pushes this one out to backward point. No addition to the score.
Also on Saturday, it was a good bit of breeze up here. It was nice. It felt like it was AC up on this scaffold. But I look around the fields and look at these flags. not a man moved.
Not moving at all. They forgot to turn on the fans up here. My goodness.
We came across Ferry Reach this morning around about 7:30, and it was glass.
Yeah.
Ferry Reach was glass.
No breeze here. Not yet.
Okay, well, call him then. <needs to call.
laughs> I think the night before, on the Wednesday night, I saw the tarpaulin flying all over the place.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just from the, from the house. Just
looked that looked good.
Yeah. It's a shorter delivery. And Frey patted it down. No addition to the score.
So far, Sean, and what we've seen so far, and good work from the groundsman. The wicket has been pretty hard to.
Yes.
The carry's been good.
Yes.
The bounce has been good. And I expect it for at least 2 days.
Yep. It's really beautiful here today. Zico Burgess again. This one, he turns on the onside. They hustle through quickly for a single. Goes around to backward of square. They go through quickly for, is that two?
Yep.
Two for Frey. Two for Frey. And Frey moves on to three. And Somerset move on to five. Five without loss. This one is wide outside the off stump. Thank you.
light.
It's a very slight drizzle. May dampen the ground, but it certainly won't dampen the spirits of all of these thousands and thousands of people here at Wellington Oval. Absolutely beautiful. In comes Burgess again. And this one, shot, a beautiful shot. Stroke from Taryn Craig. He flicks it off his pads around to the backward square leg boundary for four. Four runs. Four runs. That's the end of the over. End of three overs. The score here at Wellington Oval. Somerset are nine without loss. Chris Douglas has two. Taryn Frey has seven. You're listening to the 2023 Annual Cup Match Classic live from St. George with the voice of summer on Magic 102.7 and Hot 107.5.
Did you know that you can book your doctor's appointments online? Moongate Medical, Bermuda's newest general practice, makes it simple and easy to schedule your physicians right from where you are, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For general checkups, TCD appointments, sick notes, and prescription advice, we are here for you. Do you need an exceptional, compassionate, and trustworthy physician? Dr. Karen Fedlin and Dr. Andrea Guilford can accept your appointment today. Call 295-4265 or save time and book online at moongatemedical.bm. Moongate Medical, better health for a better quality of life.
We know life can be unpredictable, like the outcome of a cricket match. But at Bermuda Motors, our team is united by a shared passion for cars and an even greater passion for making your dreams come true. That's because your happiness and satisfaction are our ultimate rewards. Bermuda Motors, with the power of care, drives us to serve you better.
And welcome back to Wellington Oval. Delry Rollinson just built his first ball in the fourth over. This ball is spinning away from Taryn Frey. Score is 10 now. 10 without loss. Taryn Frey on 7. Chris Douglas on 3. Rollinson. Ball pitched on the off stump. Refrains for defense. Rollins runs in again to Frey. Where this one spins away from. Gets past umpire. Mias wicketkeeper. Sinclair Smith. Ten without loss. As St. George has won the toss this morning and sent Somerset into bat. Rollins' left arm around. Pitches one up to a full pitch to Frey. He just neatly places on the one side, looking for two. They get two comfortably as Smith runs out. Rollins having a quick word with Captain Bascom. So Rollins has Rodney try that first slip. Zende Frebert is sealing it off. Cover point. Looks like Bastion's going into his way. He's making his way into the slip, so he'll be at second slip. Actually, it must have got third slip. Actually, time to come over a bit, so closer to second slip. Rollins to Frey. So Frey's for defense. Yours has a man out in the covers. That's the end of the over. 12 without loss after four overs. So Rollins has about two overs now. Giving up four runs. Dean, is something that we're going to have to take notice. And I think when you have a longer version of this game, it's splitting the game down into sessions. You know, the early morning session. And we'll see who battled, who may have been on top, then the afternoon sessions, then the evening session. We break it down to sessions, even to hours, but let's see how the game progresses from there, and that gives us, our audience, a better way to follow the game.
Yeah, the game, you know, as we already know, the longer works, the ebbs and flows.
Yep.
And what you'll find is, you know, just looking at the sessions, St. George's will have their tactical plan, saying, listen, before lunch, let's see if we can go ahead and pick up maybe 3 wickets or maybe 4 wickets or get through the front, you know, the front line of Somerset's batting order. And again, Somerset will want to not lose anything before lunch. So if the game is broken into sessions, and you are so correct in saying it. So you can look at it, the longer version, because it's too long to look at, right? So you just got to break it up.
It's going to be Zico Burgess between from what we call the rest of it. What goes past free? Burgess along with Free. In the national squad, you have a good bit of national team players involved in cup match. Burgess runs in now. Ooh, Godfrey fishing outside the off stump. There's three slips, man. Three slips of Golly, man, a point. Short mid off, short mid on. A man on the square leg boundary. Man, that's sitting mid on. Zende Ferbic up underneath the helmet there. Burgess again. This one short. Up into Douglas. But he's able to keep it down. Drops on the onside. You think over the last few years, especially down on this wicket, Dion Stubble got hit by the ball. You would think Chris would say, put on the helmet. No. That's not going to happen. No, it's not going to happen. Burgess. Well, this one wraps on the chest this time. So he's squaring up.
Ooh.
Douglas is squaring up.
Nice. Good short deliveries.
Yeah.
Good short deliveries.
And surprising enough that Douglas has not gone for the pull or hook.
Mm.
But once again, that shows his maturity over the years because we know his younger career, he'd have been inviting that. This one's looking, he's looking to drive this. Does get it over, you know? So Burgess using some variation. A couple of short balls and one moving away from Douglas. Douglas has the red cap on. Turn free at the non-strikers, and he's under the helmet. Burgess back at his mark as he runs in now. Ooh, this one short. He's out. He's out. But what a good ball from Zico Burgess. He had Douglas fishing, and he was not sure if he wanted to drive, but was just short of a length, at the dangling length. And Douglas got an edge and a well taken catch by Sinclair Smith to his left. But he set him up for that. He set him up because he had a couple of short balls, and we know him a couple of short balls that had some going away. And that one was just a little bit tighter than the previous ball that went away, Dean.
Yeah, great delivery. Great delivery. Two short ones. And then he had the one just going outside the just missing the outside edge of the bat, going through to the wicket keep. And then again, putting it there again. Chris Douglas, you know, sort of, it looked like he was in between.
Yes.
In between two minds. And that's the brilliance of Zico Burgess, getting him in between two minds, whether to go, you know, drive or just to go forward. And through to a great catch to Sinclair Smith's left. Great catch. He took it right in front of the first slip. So good piece of glove work from Sinclair Smith. Good stuff.
So George has got to be on a high, capturing the wicket of Chris Douglas, as he's been a thorn in that side for the last 5 to 6 years. The top order of this lineup. But if you get rid of Chris early, that brings Trey Mendes to the crease.
I mean, mentioned earlier, between the three of them, they have been decorating the school board over the last few years. Trey Manders has batted 11 innings and have scored 400 runs already. He's averaging 36 runs in cup match. When you look at these three guys, Terrence Frey averaging 43, Chris Douglas averaging 40, and Trey Manders averaging 36. To get Chris Douglas early, they're going to be up on it right now.
Yeah.
And that was the end of the over, too. That was the over ball. 12 for 1 after 5 overs here at Wellington Oval. Want to say good morning to Inter Island Communications family. Ryan back at the station. I see the big man himself. He's made his presence here today, Mr. Glenn Blakeney. Nice to see him today. 12 for the loss of 1. Two years ago, Chris Douglas scored 128 in the first innings. Today, dismissed for 3. Dowry Rollins now to Terrence Frey. Pitched up a bit. Oh, he could be out too. He could be out too.
No, he's saying not out.
Oh, saying not out. Saying not out. As Frey looking to drive that ball spun away, Wickieber took the ball, and the players were definitely excited. Frey stood there, and umpire said, not out.
No. So that's what you want. That's what you want.
We mentioned about the body language when
that's
you were right.
Tough, that's
right?
What you want, excitement.
You have it here.
Put
now,
the
right?
Pressure on.
Put the pressure
everybody,
on. There you go.
Everybody making noise.
That's right.
Dowry Rollins. Oh, aborts is looking at something as the players are not still yet. An umpire is going to remind them they have to be completely still.
They have to maintain control of this game, because once they lose control, then it all gets out of hand.
That ball spins away from Frey as outside the off stump. Also good to see a very attacking feel from St. George's. I think that was also lacking the last few years. When they did get a wicket, they let the pressure off. But the field placement right now is very attacking. And first slip. Wide second slip. A leg slip. Ceiling it off. Man, it's short cover. It's going to be short mid on, mid off, mid wicket. And then on the cover boundary. Dowry Rollins again to Frey. Frey is a full pitch. Let's check the swing. Pushes out in the covers and goes through for 1. Rollins led him off on a bad ball. And that's going to bring Trey Manders now. Very small in stature, but very potent in size. Of all the years watching him, Dean, doesn't seem like much bothers him when it comes to pressure.
No, it doesn't.
Who's that?
Trey Manders.
Oh, no.
Rollins to Manders. And he's driving at that, looking to get off the mark, but hit straight to Brian Hall.
That's one young man who is excited beyond comparison.
Man, man, I got some stories with you and Brian, man.
Boy, oh boy. But you know, the thing is, he's worked hard.
Oh, yes.
This is the culmination of years and years of commitment, hard work, practice, dedication to this sport. I'm happy to see him playing today. He deserves it.
This one's short where Manders on the back foot plays it out to the cover point region.
You know, when we talked about the history of cup match, I think he's played a cup match before he even played a cup match, because his dad probably telling him so much about cup match.
Fourteen for the loss of 1. Rollins
Left arm around. Drives it that out to the covers and get it. One. And that's the end of the over. So six overs have been completed here at Wellington Oval. The score is 15 for one. Trey Mammoth on one. Taryn Frey on 11. Out batsman Chris Douglas for three. You're listening to the 121st Cup Match Classic with the voice of summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.7.
You do you, needs more we. We do we since 1864. There's vodka. Then there's Smirnoff, Bermuda's number one vodka. Drink responsibly. Available across the island at the Follows Lightborn stores, 127 Front Street, City of Hamilton, and 30 Harbor Road, Paget. And now available on Pronto. Download the app for more information.
Cup Match Weekend is good like the match being played on your end of the island. It's good like eating your favorite Bermudian dish. It's good like wearing your team's colors all week long. It's good like celebrating with your friends and family. And of course, it's good like bragging rights when your team wins. CG Insurance wishes you and yours a happy and safe Cup Match Weekend. CG Insurance, good like that.
Oh, we see Seiko Barges bowling to Taryn Frey. Frey looking to square cut this. And goes through to the wicket keep. No chance of a run. Seiko Barges now in his
fourth over. Looking to get on the back foot and looking to punch this into the cover. Sorry, Bulls. They're too close to him, goes through to the wicket keeper Smith. Good ball. Good ball. Yeah. Nice and tight to him. Yeah. Two slips of belly, sealing it off, sealing it on. And back to square leg. They just watches this go through outside the off stand, going through to the wicket keeper Smith. There's mid-off, everyone's close in. No chance of a single, everyone missing. The only person that is out maybe 10 yards off the boundary is Aaron Douglas, who's an extra couple of points. But just... they're looking to hop. Oh, he gets a top edge. And goes over the wicket tip into the boundary wall, right in front of us. Goes for four. He's looking to hook, but he gets a top edge. And Somerset now on 19 for one. Didn't get a win, but of course, he made it to keep it.
Very important thing about that stroke, he went hard. That's right. He's going to go very hard.
That's right. It's true. Need to get inside, top edge. That's how you say, check the scoreboard. I think it's a. Yeah, Somerset now 19 for 1. Taryn Frey now on 15. And Mandos just coming to the wicket for 1. It's back to us now. Frey looking to turn this one, hits his head. Looking to make a shot. Turn this one down the right side, but hits his head and not appeal.
Goes through to Charles Travis, Green and Daly.
Seiko Barges now, last ball of this over. Rose, he cleaned the wicket of Chris Douglas. That is the first. So, oh, gets forward. Looking to this one. He gets an inside edge, goes backward of Square Daryl runs his feeling short and no chance of a run. That is the end of the over. It's the end of the seventh over this morning. Trey Mandos, the new batsman. batsman was Chris Douglas, who was out for three. He was caught behind by, good catch behind by Zeke Rosales. Off the bowling of Zeke Rogers, who was now rolled 4 overs. He's just given up 12 runs for 1 wicket. Darryl Williams has rolled 3 overs, and he's given up 7 runs. And he will return with his left arm from the eastern end with his one slip, third slip, fully mid on, fully mid off, mid on and mid off, and he has a extra couple of boundary. Here comes Darryl on the left arm orthodox.
He could be out, he could be out. It's a loud appeal. The umpire has not moved. Farrington hasn't moved.
Hit the ground.
Right. And it looks as though he hit the ground. The deviation looks like it hit the ground. I think he's going to have a word with the spear leg umpire. I'm not too sure. You might want to check and see if the catch was taken cleanly.
I believe
Tremendous is, you know, he's indicating that he hit the ground, but the umpires have had a word. The umpire is going back to his original position. I'm not too sure if he's going to give him out. He will consult the umpire, and we're waiting on a signal, and he's not out. The umpire has signaled not out. So Tremendous again, he's signaled, and, you know, hit the ground. It was a lot of political catch. By the slip fielder in the track. But those decisions are very, very close. And of course, we don't have the technology where we have the snicker and all that other stuff that they actually have. Obviously, so I think we have to respect the umpire's decision.
Yeah.
And we have to just go ahead and get on with the game.
So you refer to the spearlead umpire. It's not much. All you can say is the catch was taken behind because from his advantage point, he would not be able to move for his
No, not at all. No, not at all. Not at all. So they continue. Rollins. Tremendous. Full pitch, and this one gets what it deserves. A full pitch, it gets what it deserves, and also, and it was this one was great. Picked a smash for 4 into the squirrel boundary. The umpire has signaled no ball. Lucky for sure.
That's right.
You know what? I was looking for it. I was looking for it. I'm on a big mark. Tremendous inning into the squad. Yes, exactly. Summits are now moved to 20-4. Tremendous success total into 5. Rollins. Left arm orthodox. To Mendes. This one is wide outside the left stump, and it just looks like Rollins is struggling a bit just to find his length, just to get into a rhythm. You know, we saw the previous over, he's trying to, you know, just trying to get his length. So it's going to take him a little while to just get in that rhythm. This one is short and it's going through to the wicket keep. Now it's looking to push it, but it goes through to the keeper. Well collected there by Smith. Well, and see to Mendes. Mendes watches this one going to the keeper's glove. This one is actually at the rear stump. A bit of turn going away from the right handed batsman. No run. This one is high, wide, another no ball, wide outside the off-stump. This one is cut. Backward a split, backward a point for 4. High and wide. The other one was high and wide on the left side. This one was high and wide outside the off-stump. And Mandis smashes it into the backward. And he takes his total on to 9, and it looks as though Rollins here at the eastern end is struggling a bit just to kind of dip in the ball. There's a bit of free runs. Rollins into, and this one is, again, good length. Just outside the airstop, good length. Two balls left in this over. We get two more balls.
What he is getting, though, is bounce.
Definitely.
Spinach went along a little bit of bounce.
Rollins. Oh, this one. He plays forward and it goes to. Doesn't look like keep it collected again. Go see for a single, could be a bye run. It is a bye run. Amanda stood there for a period of time. He wasn't sure where the ball went. No go through for a single. Sensabaugh, 31 for the lowest of one.
And the cloud that was hanging over. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone. What ball is that?
Absolutely. Rollins. Fake, that's in the back foot, punches this one to the hat-trick on the boundary, is picked up by Alan Douglas, and that is the end of a lengthy over. Barry Rollins now, he's called for this for 19. Zico Burgess, he's called for this for 12. Play now goes on to 16. And members on 9, 32 for 1. 32 for 1. Yes, enjoy this playing the wicket of Chris Douglas, who was caught there by Sigler Smith. Talking over that to Douglas. Just enjoy this. Within the first hour, I think one of the game plans and just speaking to the coach, Chris Smith. You imagine that he takes the, you know, targets within the first half, and not what they were looking to get within the first half, they were looking to get to with the first half, and not what to see if they can go ahead and get a vote to. So it's somewhat tactical, if you like that, to just Rico Badges, he's going to be going into his fifth over. He's going to be taking it from the top here on the western end of the field. Two slips. Bali, silly middle on, silly middle off. Slip, here comes Badges. He's going to be going to. Canfo Frey drives this one. This is the outside edge, but handsomely drives this one. This is the outside edge. Goes to, rushes to Alan Douglas, who's feeling at point. He's just off the boundary wall. Could be about 5 yards off the boundary wall. Douglas back at his mark. Into Frey. Frey gets on the back foot. Good solid back defense. Goes to Azendo Frey, who is feeling right underneath him. And he's feeling middle off. Should I just transfer this mark? Into Frey. Frey, that's this one. A good little shot. He's and he walks this one. Also, he walks this one into the mid-wicket boundary for 4. Frey now goes on to 20. That was a good fast goal hook shot. He's on to 20. Something now for 36. Something now 36 for the rest of the money. That is into Frey. Frey again on the back foot, turns his one around the corner. It's just a back defense. Frey looking to stabilize the innings with his experience and his maturity, and this is
one of the batsmen that's in George's foot. Surely need to send that to the pavilion if they're looking to get any inroads. He is definitely the pillar of one of Somerset's. Here comes Burgess into four figures on the back foot again. But that defense goes out to point where Alan Douglas is. Right here, St. George still had the attacking field, not allowing Somerset to have any scoring singles. So it's definitely boundary ball. So Ezekiel Burgess into Frey. Frey gets forward, goes to mid one, which is picked up by Garner. No chance in the run. The field is again in extremely tight, and that is the end of the over. Somerset at 36-1. You're listening to Cupnets 2023 with the Grace of Summer on Hot 107 and Magic 102.7.
Magic Imaging is a boutique style imaging center located in Potter Mountain, offering diagnostic imaging services such as ultrasounds, obstetrics, pediatric ultrasounds, and mammography. We pride ourselves in delivering the standard of healthcare and guarantee your physician a complete report for 24 hours of service. Ocean Imaging is located in Suite 308 International Center, 25th Community Avenue. You can follow us today on Facebook or on our website at OceanImaging.com. Call us for your next appointment at 297-6863-297. Be sure to ask about our new machine, the NVIDIA Avis, the automated ultrasound system. That number again is 297-6863. All future care and hip clients welcome.
It's 36-1 here at Wellington Oval as Delray Rollins is burning left arm around the wicket to the right-hander Trey Mandis. Mandis has 9, and on striker Terran Ferry has 20. And Somerset of 36-1. Rollins is burning with 2 men in the slips. There's a silly mid off, a silly mid on. He's burning left arm around the wicket. Mandis raises his bat and watches this one go by. Well, through to the wicketkeeper, Sinclair Smith, sending right up on the stumps. There's 2 men in the slips, silly mid off, silly mid on. And an extra cover, mid off, mid on, as Mandis bounces this one around the corner, and it's right into the hands of Makai Simmons at mid wicket. He is out. He's out. Trey Mandis is out. The 9, and Somerset have lost their second wicket on 36. 36 for 2. The disappointed Mandis, who obviously didn't see Simmons standing there in the rushing on the mid-wicket boundary, is walking back dejected to the Somerset at 36 for 2. Yeah, he's definitely upset with himself for that ball once again. That ball should win the money, but also was shot right on the middle stop, and he could not see the field on the boundary. He couldn't see him because he went for it, and he got. It's one of those things you gotta go, you know, you're gonna move. That's right.
And that's, I think he was probably able to see it too high.
Once again,
should I go? Should I, you know?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Once again, too high. This is tricky. You can get out on good balls, but you can also get out on bad balls.
Right. Yeah.
And it only takes, I know it's a cliche, but it takes one ball to get a man out.
Yes.
And you can have all of the predictions and make all of the analysis you like before the game. The game, if the game is clean on the field, that's where it makes a difference. That's where it all happens. Right? How you doing? All right. That's where it all happens. Don't forget to follow us on Voice of Summer, PDA. Our social media team is around, all around the field. Our special guest will be following with us, Mr. Photogenic himself. He'll be around with our social media team tomorrow. This guy's a legend on Instagram. Oh, is he? Mr. Photogenic himself. So he'll be part of our social media team tomorrow. We're happy to have him with the Voice of Summer. 36 for 2. Al J. Richardson has gone out there to join Terran Ferry, the vice captain. Excitement all around this ground. This is absolutely beautiful. Spectacular. top match really is the best of Bermuda. It really is. It's a beautiful sight to behold. Nothing better than this. Number four, that way Rollins will be bringing the left arm around the wicket with two men in the slips. This is silly men off, a silly men on, as Richardson is beaten by this one. Driving and playing on the pad. This one he pushes on the one side. Yeah, this one he pushes on the one side. So, they go through for a single. So LJ Richardson is off the mark. And the score is 37-2. 37-2. This bring on LJ Richardson is opened up as a count. Left arm around the wicket. And Ferry drives at this one. It's an outside edge, and it goes through to The end of 10 overs, 37-2. Here at Wellington Oval. And it looks as if there's going to be a change in bowling. That's also something that St. George's Thompson has done with Pools in the last few cup matches. Great team of bowlers quite often.
Yeah.
That's key. Yeah. You know, unless one bowler is making a particular impact, keep them fresh. Keep them fresh.
Yeah.
Keep rotating the bowlers.
And it's so important now because they haven't had much cricket.
That's right. That's our own little stuff.
That's right.
It's a beautiful day down here in St. George's. The sun is shining, clouds way off into the distance. And so it's going to be Rodney Trott. And the first one, RJ Richardson, is bowled defensively. Rodney tried again. And Richardson drives this one all along the ground up into the covers. Spilled it out there by Simmons. And this one they drive it's towards long, being chased by Brian Hall, who picks it up just in front of the boundary. Yes, it just in front of the boundary, and it will go through for no, it doesn't stop it, so it's 4 runs. For 4 runs. 4 runs for four runs for LJ Richardson. So he moves on to 5. Rodney Trott again. Right arm over. And this one drives down the wicket. Sean, there's a new one, Sean. We have people listening to us all the way from Bangkok. Wow, strong. That's the marvels of technology and the internet. Listening and watching. And you want to have a cup next to your shots. Getting messages from Africa, Thailand, UK. Yeah, back to Richardson. Richardson plays this one back down the wicket. And there's no addition to the score. That's the end of the over. 41 for 2 is the score after 11 overs. 41 for 2. 41 for 2 after 11 overs. That was Robbie Tuck's first over. And so it's going to be. Yes, we do that. What about? He's going 5 overs, 1 for 20. Checking with a three man this last that's no 9. So we mentioned about the top order of Samson. The batsman who had been dismissed early this morning. Dolly Roberts was turned around for chess. And Faith started it in.
Delray Rollins, left arm around, a full toss, and Frey spotted it and cracked it out to the cover point boundary area, where it's fielded by, that looks like Alan Douglas out there in the country. They go through for a comfortable single. It was chest height, so it wasn't really, because it was on the offside, it wasn't really comfortable for doing what I'm sure he would have liked, or what had it been pitched elsewhere on another line, he would have given it what it richly deserved. And this one, he drives down towards long on. It's being chased by Derek Brangman, who will pick it up in front of the boundary, and they go through for 2. That's no, that's Trott. Not Brangman. That's Charles Trott. Yes, yeah, Charles Trott. Sorry, wrong team. Yeah, yes, Derek Brangman, same size, but wrong team. Delray Rollins to LJ Richardson, who punches that one out to cover point. And they go through for a comfortable single. And so LJ Richardson moves on to 8. And Somerset move on to 45 for 2. Short and wide outside the off stump. I think that got away from Rollins. And so they go through for a single as as Frey punches it out again to Douglas out there in the shadows of the scaffolding on the cover point boundary. Rollins again. Again, Rollins. He's having difficulty there. This one gets away from him. It's a no ball, and it goes out to Douglas in the covers as they go through for, was that 2?
Yeah, that's the third one.
Yeah.
It's a no ball call, and they go through for 2. So LJ Richardson moves into double figures with 10, and Somerset are on 49. And 49 Sean, for 2.
And Sean, just to make note, we see Trady Gibbons is actually going off, and Luke Horan, he's actually feeling mid-wicket there. He's making his first appearance all right. As well. Yeah, the reserve.
Good.
Yeah, Luke Good Horan. Yeah.
And this one, LJ Richardson punches down towards third man. They go through for 2. So that's 2 for LJ Richardson, and Somerset move on to 51 for 2. 51 for 2. And LJ Richardson has 12. Somerset's 50 coming in 11.5 overs. It's 55 minutes. Five of those are extras. Al J. Richardson drives this one back down the wicket. Delray Rollins fields to his own bowling. No balls. Fires to have a few, another delivery in this over. A short. And Al J. Richardson turns this one on the onside. It's fielded there by Brian Hall. And that's the end of the over. End of the over. And it looks as if it's going to be the water break. It's going to be water break. And for water break, we are going to be... Yes, so, no, it's not the water break yet, but it will be momentarily. So the first water break. So we'll give you the schedule of play. Water breaks. The game, of course, started at 10, and day one goes from...
And so I encourage anybody who may feel like it, come on down. This is going to be a weekend.
That's right. I went into HSBC yesterday. You guys had the gumballs, the snowballs. You guys really screwed it over.
I mean, I think, well, what other holiday, you know, I mean, for me, it's always as big as Christmas. The staff love it too, right? And I think for me, it's really special that we bring it into Hamilton. We're out in Somerset and St. George. And this is a time for the community, right? So the Gumbays were in, we had a great time, they brought the energy too, so that was fantastic, and the whole of Front Street was jumping, so it's all good.
Really, absolutely phenomenal, and it really just shows the commitment to the community and how you just really invested so much into the community, into the community spirit, being a part of what really is. And thank you enough for making for investing so much into the holiday, the event, the annual Puffins Classic.
Thank you.
So happy to have you. We'll tell you more to you, of course, on the holiday. You're always welcome. We hope to have you back as the game is about to resume. That's right. The game is about to resume. That way, Rollins is bowling from the eastern end, where directly below our sports microphone. He's bowling to Terrence Say, who pushed that one through the fence. We've got Cinto Smith, one of your HSBC boys, vice captain of St. George's, I'm sorry, behind the stumps there. And,
good game so far, too.
Yes,
so
very
well. Yeah. Exactly. Not too well. That's right.
Rollins to LJ Richardson, who drives this one out in the field, and so we're not going to just below our sports microphone. Somerset 58 for 2 after 13 overs. Rollins to Richardson, who pushes this one out to the covers. It's fielded out there at the cover point. It's 58 for June. Gray has 24. Making a strike, and Richardson has 17. And then straight from Faye, he drives this one out. It's fielded here by slow down by Trout, and ultimately fielded by. And maybe he's open for the singles. 9 for 2. Faye has 25. Richardson has 17. And this is a lovely stroke from Richardson. Puts this one right over the square leg boundary for 6. 6 runs. 6 runs. And LJ Richardson moves on to 23. Somerset Martin to 65 for 2. Yeah, it's Derry should have any trouble handling the ball, but he's from short. Actually, going off the field now, so Jonathan Smith looks like he's going to replace him. Yes, could have done some medical treatment. He did have arm sleeve on, yeah, he just took it down, so he might go get some treatment. There is him as well. Well, he's made 7 overs for 39 runs. Yes, a little. He's been having difficulty with his line, with his length, especially with his length. Yes, and so he's now gone off. St. George have an abundance of space. Yeah. Now he's got to sit down now. This young man wished us all happy emancipation day, happy cup match. I said, oh, you and your family, I hope you get to come by and see me early in the day before he gets to make his rounds. Good morning, your name, son?
My name is
Gerald. This is David Gerald back in second. Pleasure to meet you. I'm sure I just took the wrong picture. We'll talk to you in a minute. So we see now. Young Trump, voting from the Western End, who has they 25, some sort of 65 for two. And say, so for years, these were the rules, and then these became the rules. So he is on youth. I'm also going for Jim. It's frustrating. It's not giving up on this yet. Dropped only with 2 men in the slips. And at the point, and that's the cover, mid off, mid on, mid bishop, backhand square leg, and silly mid on right there. Dropped last down with the wicket to the right hander, Karen Fay. Loud appeal. I saw Fay's left on the card. Mr. Keynes, the umpire in duty, says not. Stephen Keynes will be at the western end of the square leg with Mr. Emerson Carey. Let's be tired. Let's start off in a minute. What's that for? Oh, end of the over. End of the over. So it's going to be Rodney Trott, the French Indian side. Rodney Trott. Rodney Trott will be bowling from the eastern end, directly below our strips microphone. Rodney Trott is going to be giving up 9 runs. An average of 4.5 runs per over. Simple math. 2 overs, 9 runs, 4.5 runs per over. That's all for free.
Yeah, now you're trying to run jokes. You guys are going to start to work at it.
I don't know. I've read that in your bio. Rodney Trott right on over to the right hander. There's a loud appeal for an RBW. And the line is sometimes on the side. We're just complaining. Well, they want another one. That doesn't, never works. Never works. And the referee is when I don't see it. I'm sorry, I switch right.
Never works.
And the referees just went like this.
I'm right. Get your sports right. Come on, Preem.
Jason, you see how I'm being roughed up right now?
I see.
No, you all invited me for an interview. And you're just roughing me up.
No. It's called banter.
But, well, don't forget, the umpires get paid to do this job. So. It's not voluntary.
Rodney tried again. Rolling from the eastern end below our sports microphone. And, momentarily, I'm going to be off here, but we are all back, I believe. So I've got a million messages in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
So thanks to everybody, all the tech people around the field. Try right arm over. And Frey, punches this one down to the backward or short third man area where the captain, Anais Bascom, fields.
Okay, punch this one out. Forward.
Gray punches this one out to forward gully, deep forward gully, or cover point. They go through, no, they don't. Yes, they go through for a single. So that's one to Frey. Frey has 27. We'll give you a rundown on the order of play. Play this morning is from 10 till 12:50 when lunch is taken, as Rodney Trott spins this one up to Richardson, who drives it back down the wicket. And that's the end of the 16th over. Somerset have 67 for 2. Al J. Richardson has 23. Terran Frey has 27. We're going to have a conversation with a young man. He tells me his name is Edward Gerald David Burt. Did I get that right?
Edward David Gerald Burt II.
Edward David Gerald Burt II. And what sort of work do you do, sir?
I'm a public servant.
Public servant. All right. We have the pleasure of talking to E. David Burt, the Premier of Bermuda. Welcome, sir. And happy cup match to you.
Happy cup match to you as well, my friend. I hope that you all are doing well on this fine and wonderful Emancipation Day.
Nothing better than this, is it?
Not at all.
Nothing bigger than cup match. Nothing better than cup match. The weather has turned out to be spectacular despite everything that we've seen over the last couple of days. And the atmosphere is electric. It just doesn't get any better than
you call it spectacular. I call it hot.
Well, it's not because you're walking around, working the room, as they say. We're sitting here working hard, but it's absolutely wonderful, isn't it?
It is, it's a pleasure to be back out here today and wish everyone a very happy Emancipation Day.
Yeah, we see Charles Trott bowling from the western end, left arm over the wicket to the right-hander, Terran Frey. Frey has 27. L.J. Richardson, the non-striker, is on 23. Charles Trott's bowling his second over from the western end, bowling with two men in the slips, of one man at backward of point, one man at cover point, mid-off, mid-on, silly mid-on, forward mid-wicket, as Frey drives this one and it goes directly to Alan Douglas Jr. at point. No addition to the score.
Sean, I've named that area, especially that wall, Alan Douglas's wall. I don't see his name over there yet. Dean, please get to management. He's taken quite a bit of catches over there.
Yes, he has.
Ooh, look at that. Spectacular catches, too.
So I missed earlier when someone got out, and I thought that they said, so was it a catch over there?
Simmons. Mekhi Simmons.
Yes. Huh? Good catch.
Yeah, Mekhi Simmons. Mekhi Simmons.
Jason, I would like it. Like he was going to be 4 runs.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, like it. He was up. I don't think he saw him standing over there. Frey pushes this one out into the covers, and it's Gibbons who fields. Treadwell Gibbons.
He went off for a couple of overs. He's back on.
Yes, we saw young Luke Horan. But he was classed as a junior reserve earlier, but he's made his debut in the Classic. This one outside the off stump, and Frey watches it go by. Trot. Back at his mark and turns. Comes in left arm over the wicket to Terran Frey. A slower delivery. Pitched it up, and Frey pushes it back down the wicket. It's field there mid-off, and
that felt like a maiden.
No addition. It was a maiden? No, I think they got a run in there.
No.
Yep, it's the end of the over, and but it wasn't a made run in there. 17 overs have been booed, 68-2. So, Mr. Premier, what's your plans for this cup match? You'll be here all day for 2 days, won't you?
Absolutely.
I know you love cup match.
Last ball.
First ball to the last ball.
See, my first guests are arriving in yesterday. We got more coming in today. I think there are 8 coming in today, more coming in tomorrow.
From overseas?
Absolutely.
You always have a camp, don't you? You're really invested in this.
You have to understand. I mean, it used to be my camp. Now it is just a camp that I'm a part of.
You've taken it over.
Exactly. That's the thing. It is now a camp that I'm a part of. But I am there, and it's fine. My father, he put his little side thing on because there's a whole bunch of, you know, commotion on a Friday, so he wanted to make sure it got set off, so he got his nice little drink stand and everything
else. Just leave him alone. Let him watch the game. That's right. Don't get in his way. It's a different generation, you know. Mm-hmm. This is more important to him than all of that action going on up there.
Lovely stroke from Richardson.
And it's 4 runs.
Young
Richardson turns that one around to the square leg boundary. And Richardson was a yes.
See, I surprised you with my cricket terminology, didn't I? I see that strike rate right there, 122.7.
Don't get excited. He moves on to 27, and Somerset move on to 72 for 2.
Is that simple math as well?
Yes. Well, that's his score. That's how many balls he's faced. That's the strike rate. All right.
Really, Sean?
That's wow. Right. That's right. We might get you a job in finance. Oh, dear. So, Richardson has 27. He's faced 22 deliveries. Terran Frey has 27, and he's faced 56 deliveries.
Yeah, then we'll pull the man who was at point boundaries and spring all the way around to backward square and put him on the boundary.
Yes, he'd be better. He'll do better there. The young Douglas is around on the backward square leg boundary. Rodney Trott will be bowling right arm over the wicket to the right-hander, Richardson. Richardson is beaten. Smith whips off the bales, lightning speed. There's a loud appeal to Mr. Keynes, the square leg umpire, for stumping. But Mr. Keynes shakes his head and says not out. This match has been really evenly matched, this game, all morning.
You were talking about banter? You know the banter that I was talking this morning?
And as Richardson drives this one over the head of the long off fieldsman right down to the boundary for 4. 4 runs. And so LJ Richardson moves on to 31. 31 for LJ Richardson, and Somerset have 76 for 2. Rodney Trott again, right arm over. And Richardson pushes this one out to short extra cover, where it's fielded by Trott. And Richardson drives this one again over the head of Brian Hall down at long off. But this one don't carry to the boundary. Wow. And so they have to run through and be satisfied with 2 as Hall chases it down, cuts it off. It didn't reach the boundary, so they only get 2 with that one. And so Richardson moves on to 33, and Somerset 78 for 2. 78 for 2. And that's the end of the over. End of 18 overs, 78 for 2. LJ Richardson, 33. Terran Frey, 27. 18 overs have been bowled. You're listening to Cup Match 2023 live from Wellington Oval with the voice of summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.7.
Strikes, Hennessy, and Syrah present a Leo birthday bash. It's all taking place Saturday, August 12th at the Strikes Lounge in St. David's. Early drink specials on Hennessy and Ciroc from 8 to 10 p.m. DJ Selecta Frey. Then at 10 p.m., it's Soja One, Juggling J, Haley Hypes, and Mikey B. It's $20 at the door. Must be 21 and over to party. Early drink specials on Hennessy and Ciroc. Also, VIP section, bubble serves only. Don't forget to follow us on IG, Strikes Bowling Lounge. It's the year-to-year Leo Birthday Bash, Saturday, August 12th at the Strikes Lounge in St. David's. Sponsored by Hennessy and Ciroc.
Welcome back to Wellington Oval. It's Terran Frey, pushes 102 mid off. Not fielded. Go through 4-2, looking for 3. Scores 80 now, 80 for the loss of 2. In batsman, LJ Richardson, he's on 33 after facing 27 deliveries. And Terran Frey opened up, he's on 29. He's on strike now after facing 58 deliveries. It's going to be Onias Bascom. He's going to go into short extra cover. Charles Trott aborts his run up.
I think somebody wants to tell it. What's the bit us to do?
I'm just getting set up with these binoculars. So I can actually see what happens when you turn 40. Your eyes start to go.
Yes.
And I didn't bring my glasses today, so this is the best I'm going to see the match.
Maybe when he turns 50, sure.
That's right.
This one's up just out of the reach of Anais Bascom at short extra cover. As Frey goes through for one more. He's now on 30. We are in the 19th over. So we appreciate you coming through. Do not
be a stranger.
Be a stranger.
I won't be a stranger. I won't see you tomorrow, though. I might see you the rest of the day. We'll see. Might give you some commentary. Right. You might come and help out Mr. Tucker with some, you know, some analysis.
You're always welcome, sir. You're always welcome.
Oh, this one is appeal for catch behind as Charles Trott just wide of the off stump. As Richardson driving at that. Umpire Keynes had nothing to do with it. He's at the western end. Emerson Carrington is at the square leg at the eastern end. Charles Trott back at his mark. The left arm over to Richardson. Ooh, that ball got up a bit, just short, but jumped up. Smith did well to collect. Dean, we talked about Sessions the first hour and a bit. And I would have think St. George's would have won that session, picking up those two wickets early in the match. This one's played out to the onside, but since which?
I think just the first hour.
Yep. Somerset has
fighting back.
Now fighting back with, I believe, a 45-run partnership.
Yes, yes.
And we're going to talk more about Sessions and partnerships as what's needed from the winners.
So
we will go through 2 days, and those two words, Sessions and partnership.
Yep.
Who has the best session? Who has the best partnerships?
Yep.
I guarantee by at the end of 2 days, they'll be deemed the winner.
Of course, of course. Jason, you said it right. Again, these two experienced batsmen, you see it. It's going to come through the character of the top line of Somerset batsmen. Yeah, okay, you're going to get one or two, but you have to stay on top. You got to have some good bowling lines, good lengths, and you got to be really, really strict and tight. So this is what St. George's challenge is right now.
Rodney Trott will continue from the eastern end. Better flight to Frey. Trott back home at Bailey's Bay. With Frey. So they have a lot of practice time. Umpire asking Trott to make sure once he delivers the ball, he makes his way off the pitch.
Giants game. A little bit of flight. Now, after this, we'll talk a little bit about the consistency and the lack of consistency of bowling we've seen so far this morning. And why, what could be some of the reasons? And we've heard many times from both coaches the lead into cup match preparation. Trot.
Here we go.
Bring out in the front foot. Give them respect.
Trot. This one's off his pad. Into the hands of Sabbath.
Two to go.
See me out here today. Another
Trot. Free. This one's off his pad. Into the hands of Ferbert, another teammate of Bayless Bay. I know the president of Bayless Bay very happy. He's got quite a bit of his players here represented between both teams. And that's the end of the over. So Rodney Trot has bowled 5 overs. 1 maiden, none for 20. So preparation leading up to cup match, there was a lack of playing, especially we had a knockout tournament prior. And both Somerset and St. George, St. George first, but then Somerset got knocked out early, meaning that there's two league teams hadn't played serious cricket for 3 to 4 weeks.
Yeah.
How does that play now when you're trying to get some type of normalcy? Because you can do all the training you want, but how does game time really affect bowlers?
Okay, so I'm going to give you from a wicketkeeper and a coach's standpoint. Bowling is very technical. It is extremely technical. It's technical to coach, but also on top of that, for a bowler. All right. So all I would say is just that it's just like anything. It's repetition. You have to, going into cup match, you would want to have a number of games underneath your belt, a number of opportunities to bowl. That's part of your rhythm.
This one pitched up right in the, oh man, the power section of Richardson, and he places a 3 extra cover for 4. And we've seen, like I said, of an over pitch or too short.
That's what you've seen. In the beginning, St. George's were very tight with the lines. I would say, you know, 3 good balls, of course, 3 bad balls. Now we've actually seen sort of 4 bad balls and then 2. Right. So, again, when we're talking about bowling, it's an art form. You got to put your time in. You got to put your mileage in. And, you know, it's a rhythm.
That one's overpitched. The full pitch. That's one just checked his swing. It goes towards Cow Corner. Forward mid wicket and go through for 2. I've seen a lot of full pitch balls, yes. Over pitch balls. I'm wondering if the dew, hopefully, it's starting to wear off. But I wonder about the grip of the ball. And Dean, we're going to talk. I sent you on a little homework run earlier. This one short, but a quicker ball outside the off stump. This third wicket now is worth 50 runs, coming in 65 balls in 46 minutes. So we mentioned about the partnership, the 50-run partnership, been put on between Al J. Richardson and Taryn Frey. Mm-hmm. And dominated by, actually, Richardson. Mm-hmm. Trot has moved from the leg slip around to both third slip. Trot. Richardson driving. Good stop there by Brian Hall. One thing, that young man, he gives us 100% no matter what he does. A little story about Brian. So, obviously, we knew he has talent as a hard hitter.
Mm-hmm. He's been getting wickets throughout the season, well, last few years. This one's going over the head of extra covers. High, 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 back. They go through for two. And sitting down with him at one of the top match training sessions, he had mentioned, because he's also been driving go-karts through the last couple of seasons, and he's saying how much that have helped him focus. Because go-karting, you got to get up 5 o'clock and see what you got to do before you go race. And it's an all-day scene. Whereas cricket, some guys are getting up all or two just before and going to play. And attention to detail, because you're an engine. So it's taught him to really focus on from early in the morning, but all week leading to that day.
Yeah.
And it's took that into cricket. Well, and you see the fruits of labor.
And you know, I always tell people, all sport are interrelated.
Yeah.
If you look at golf,
yeah,
go-karting, motor racing, you can think of any sport that has been played, swimming.
Yeah.
You know, if you think of any sport, it's always been a connection. All of them have this interconnection. Mm-hmm. So I'm so glad that he was able to use that connection piece and bring it over to cricket. And it's actually has helped him.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I'm not getting in a go-kart. I'm fine. It's hard enough me driving.
Hey, Peter, former service player.
I like to keep the speed limit.
Rodney Trouble continue from the Eastern End. Richardson, very strange stroke. He his follow through a lot of times his bottom hand coming off the bat. Let's try to get into Richardson. This one's just short. That's to come off his body. Very good ball from Trot. Richardson very comfortable. So in 42. So pitched on the leg stump. Doesn't get a hold of it. This one gets an edge, and it's going to beat the slips, and then you run through for two. So a bit of luck, but it's what's needed. Now he's on 44. He's overtaken his high-scoring cup match. He scored 43 2 years ago in St. George. And he's on 44. Can he get his 50? Trot to Richardson. This one, loud appeal. And he's been given out. He's been given out. As that ball was pitched on the middle stump. And he just missed it. He just missed it.
Yeah, that was a good delivery. Right on middle stump. He missed it. Missed time. He got a little bit of movement off the wicket, off the pitch.
A quick one from Trot.
Yep.
And stay low and trap LJ Richardson out in front.
Yes. Well batted.
Well batted. Well so batted. 43 in 2021.
Yes.
44 well in 2023.
Yes, well batted.
Well batted. I know he's dejected, but when he goes back and looks at it, he would have said, I was up.
Yeah.
I was up.
Yeah.
The veteran, the wily veteran, Rodney Trot, has captured the wicket of the youngster, LJ Richardson. Someone said 94 for three.
That's right.
And that brings Dion Stubble, who is the MVP, down here.
That's right. And just before lunch.
Just before lunch.
Just before lunch. So this is going to be an interesting period with Dion coming to the wicket now. You're looking at about an hour and 15 minutes before Somerset go out, before we go the first session, right? Before we go for lunch. And St. George's, to be honest with you, St. George's were in need of that wicket, Jason. They were in need. I think they started to go a bit flat. Somerset were sinking their teeth into St. George's, and I think it came at a critical time within this inning. So
Credit to St. George's for sticking to it. Credit to Rodney Trott. But it came at a very critical time in this innings.
That partnership was worth 62 runs. So you're absolutely right, Dean. They broke a big partnership that was shaping up to look like three figures. So both batsmen were looking very comfortable.
Yep.
But Dion Stubble has made his way. And Dean, he's probably one of the most intelligent. I'm not worried about the talent by far.
Of course.
Athletes. Not just cricket, an athlete.
This period right here, Dion Stubble, Taryn Frey at the wicket. Right now, I would hope, I would believe that all the St. George's players will be on the edge looking for something, because these two experienced batsmen could take this cup match away from St. George's right now. So it's very critical right now for St. George's, because Dion Stubble, Taryn Frey, that's 200s right there, easy.
Both formidable batsmen.
Both.
Match winners, either. Both.
Exactly. Others. Exactly.
Century maker.
That's right. This is cup match right now.
Trott has one more delivery. 98 for three. As Rodney Trott to Dion Stubble. Got a flight. He's driving on drive. Beautiful on drive. Looking to get us. Oh, this might be out. Oh, if he would have hit the stumps, he would have been out. So the ball was hit out to mid on. Dalry Rollins dove. It ricocheted. Dion Stubble stopped midway. And by the time he continued, if he would have handed the ball off to Trott, he would have been out. Well, they're talking it over, but it's gone.
No, not from that distance. I think Dalry is indicating to Rodney, you could have caught it and hit the stumps. From that distance, there's no way I'm standing there to take a catch. You better hit their stumps directly.
When he squared up.
Rodney got out of the way. Do you see his arms? It's no way from 5 yards I'm going to be looking to take it and hit the stumps. No, you better hit directly. Yeah, good stuff, though.
I don't know.
But that's the pressure that you want right now.
And you saw it created, right?
Yes.
Created the chance.
Yeah.
Well, it's all happening here before lunch on the first day of the 121st Classic. As Dion Stubble now, he's at the eastern end taking guard from umpire Keynes. Trott's still saying, look, man, you square it up. You don't think you want me standing behind there and catch it. I need these hands on Monday. Charles Trott will continue. From the western end. So you hear the noise around the field. St. George's fans anticipating another wicket. The Summers are looking to form another partnership. Charles Trott to Dion Stubble. Stubble's in for defense. Gets behind the ball, plays all on the own side to Azende Ferbert. Azende Ferbert looked like he's played a whole match already. Trott once again, left arm over, past umpire Keynes. This one's wide. It's driven hard and high. Hard and high. That ball raced to the boundary so fast. Not a man move. Not a man move. I was going to say the outfield was slow, but I don't think it touched the blade of grass.
That's a bullet.
Four runs. Dion Stubble. Off the middle of the bat.
Jeez.
99 for three. 99 for three. Dion Stubble on the back foot. It's going to play it into the covers. Treadwell Gibbons uses some of his goalkeeping skills. Dives to his left to prevent the run. Prevent Summerson from getting 100.
Stubble has a quick chat with Frey. As they're telling Gibbons now to go back to the boundary. So Nunn's at the cover boundary. Meantime, Zende Ferbert's tying the laces for Deion Stubble. He's back. Charles Trott to Deion Stubble. Ooh, that one jumped up. Well, watched by Stubble. 99 for three. Trott back at his mark. Makes his way in past umpire Keynes. So it's pitched up on the back foot from Stubble. Plays in front. Brian Hull has the ball now. Giving a good rub, trying to keep the shine of the ball on one side. Did I mention it earlier, but we have not seen much swing this morning. Trott to Stubble off the back foot. Beautiful cut shot, but straight to the man at backward point. And that's the end of the over.
I think Jason, to be able to get that swing that we're talking about consistently, you know, you've got to be bowling in those good areas, you know, and I think to be, I don't want to be critical, but I have to be at this point. I don't think St. George's have actually bowled in those good areas consistently, you know, as much as they should have to utilize this wicket. You know, I mean, yeah, we have three wickets down. I mean, St. George's has three wickets down, but, you know, just getting it in those good areas so we can, especially the seamers, Charles, and as well as Zico, you know, just getting it in those good areas. So a lot of discussion will probably take place during the lunch break. Mm-hmm.
Trott will continue from the eastern end. Frey out of forward defense. We are talking about bowling in the right areas. Pitched up to Frey. It'd be remiss that we're missing George O'Brien this year and what he's meant to this classic. Mm-hmm. Trott to Frey. O'Brien, if this is last year or year before, 42 wickets. Sits in 13th place all time. Took 5 for 87 as a Colt back in 2005. But been one of the most effective wicket takers for St. George's,
of course,
several years.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
Trott to Frey. A little bit of flight.
And Jason, to be fair, that could have been another talking point there in the selection process, which not much cricket has actually been played, and how would it have affected George over the two-day period?
Trott to Frey off the back foot. The 3-for-1. And that's the 100 up. Actually goes through for two. So the 101 up for Somerset.
Yep.
Yep. So 100 and the 24th over. Come to 106 minutes. Six extras. We have completed 24 overs here at Wellington Oval. The score is 101 for 3. In batsman, Deion Stubble on 5. Terrence Frey, not out on 34th. You're listening to the 121st Classic with the Voice of Summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.0.
Ultimate Imaging is a boutique-style imaging center located in the heart of Hamilton, offering diagnostic imaging services such as general ultrasound, obstetrics, pediatric ultrasound, and mammography. We pride ourselves in delivering the global standard of healthcare and guarantee your physician a complete report within 24 hours of service. Ultimate Imaging is located at Suite 308 International Center, 26 Bermudiana Road. You can follow us on Facebook or our website at ultimateimaging.bm. Call for your appointment today on 297-6863 or 29-SOUND.
Ocean Interiors Limited, specialized in high-end interior fit-outs, skilled carpentry and construction in homes, offices, hotels, and other commercial properties. Along with our core services, we offer project management. Ocean Interiors is proud of their reputation with the industry, and it's a result of our unmatched customer service, creativity, expertise, and exceptional staff. Give us a call at 441-296-2326 or email us at oceaninteriors@northrock.bm. Ocean Interiors Limited.
Hey, bro, where's the cups in here? Now I drink.
You didn't see any WhatsApp, bro?
Nah, I missed that. What happened?
You're supposed to bring your own cups.
Sirs?
Yeah, the reusable ones, not the old plastic ones that you throw away.
Okay.
We're trying to do right. Reduce waste so we can party all night. I've got the blue bags for the bottles and the cans.
All right, Captain Photo Planet.
Hey, you lot here, boy?
Yeah, hey, I've got blue bags for you guys over there too, see?
Let's all do our part to keep Bermuda beautiful. This message was sponsored by KBB and Wilmont Trucking in partnership with Recycle Bermuda.
103 for three. Zico Burgess into Dion Stubble. Turns this one around the corner to the square leg where the umpire's fielding. Then we see Azende Ferbity. He's going to pick it up. And they go through for one. So Dion Stubble moves on to six and brings Terran Frey one strike. Somerset are 102 for three. 102 for three. And Zico Burgess has taken over from the western end. He has replaced Charles Strutt. He's replaced Charles Strutt at the western end. Here comes Burgess to Frey. Frey turn. Oh, bips his one off his hip. Guides this one down to the backward square leg boundary where Makai Simmons is feeling. Go through for one. Terran Frey now on 35, brings Dion Stubble one strike. Score now is 104. 104, 103, 103. Burgess to Stubble. This one cuts back into just off the seam. Stubble goes forward defense. Deciding to go and do a bit of gardening. Walking down the wicket, patting it down. Burgess into Stubble. Stubble gets bowled forward. Good forward defense and goes to short cover fielder, the captain of St. George's, Bascom. And no run. 103 for three. Stubble on six. Just coming to the wicket. LJ Richardson, he was out. That was the last batsman. LBW for Trud. Burgess to Stubble. Yeah, yeah. Stubble again, bow forward, forward defense. Ball pitched at the off stump. He gets well forward. Solid defense. A very critical moment right here in the game. We have 1 hour before lunch. New batsman Dion Stubble to the wicket. Most recognized batsman in the Somerset dressing room. Burgess. Again, Stubble well forward. Good solid defense. And that is the end of the over. Burgess has bowled his six overs. He's had one wicket for 18 runs. And Rodney Trott, he's bowling from the Eastern, and he's bowled seven overs, one wicket for 25. So it's a very critical, critical time here at the Wellington Oval. Everyone is on the edge of their seats. And we know that in the Somerset, most experienced batsman right here, Jason.
Yeah.
Two of the most experienced batsmen. So it's critical now.
So what they're going to be looking to do, basically, get to lunch. Get to lunch.
Yep.
Settle everything down. Get to lunch. Reassess the situation. Look at the targets, because obviously they will have the targets, what they want.
Of course.
I will say the last few cup matches, Somerset has basically went to bat St. George's out of cup match on the first innings, if possible.
That's
so
right.
They'll be looking for a total to bat as long as possible on the first innings. Now, counteract that, St. George's needs to get the energy back up where it was. Mm-hmm. We see it has dropped off a bit, and to create that pressure again, because they need to keep taking wickets.
And we still see an attacking field. Here comes Rodney Trott. He's going to be bowling to Terran Frey. Frey gets well forward defense. Not much power behind the shot. He just gets forward and picked up by short cover fielder there, Charles Strutt. Right arm over the wicket. Again, a loud appeal. Umpire Carrington, not really interested, but Terran Frey gets well forward. Frey on 35. The pillar, one of the main pillars of the Somerset batting order. Trot to Frey. Frey looking to turn it to the mid-wicket area. Doesn't get much power behind the ball, but it goes to short mid-wicket fielder Darry Rollins. Trot to Frey. Frey well forward. Solid forward defense, gets well behind it. Terran Frey, the opening bat for Somerset. Steal there. Frey again, well forward, smothers the ball, gets well behind it, just gets inside edge, goes through to Treadwell Gibbons. He's going to be feeling silly mid on. Try to Frey. Frey turns his around the corner, just soft hands. Just goes short to Treadwell Gibbons. Just around the corner. That is the end of the over. Score now, Somerset, 103 for 3. Deon Stubble, he's on 6. And Terran Frey is on 35. So if we can quickly run through it very quickly. Chris Douglas, he scored 3. He was caught behind by Sinclair Smith off Ezekiel Burgess. Trey Mandis, he was caught by Mackay Simmons off the bowling of Rollins. He had 9. And LJ Richardson was LBW by Rodney Trott for 44. Those were the 3 wickets this morning. Ezekiel Burgess is going to continue from the western end. St. George is looking to take huge advantage of this overcast using Zico Burgess at the western end. Here comes Burgess into Stubble. Oh, inside edge. Goes through to the wicket keep. Stubble was going in between two mines. He's looking to hit it backward a point, but he gets a bottom edge and goes through to the wicket keep. No chance of a run. St. George's field now has, they've decided to change the field setting. Just a Stubble. Stubble goes to him back, cuts this one straight to point fielder, Alan Douglas. No chance of a run. So St. George's have now decided to, for Zeko Burgess, he's have a deep mid wicket, back, deep backward square on the boundary, extra cover boundary fielder. So three people are on the boundary, up against the boundary wall. One slip, mid on, mid off, short cover, and a point. Right arm over the wicket to Stubble. Stubble looks, oh, it gets back in. This is one forward. Forward of mid wicket, picked up by Darway Rollins, goes through for one. This is a short punched arm pull. And he takes his total one to seven, brings Terran Frey on strike. Terran Frey, 35, opening bat for Somerset. Burgess to Frey. Frey. Oh, flicks this one for six. Off his pads. Beautiful shot. Absolutely beautiful shot by Terran Frey. This one was on his pads. And he just basically flicks this one right in the slot and hits him for six, headed towards Myers. Beautiful shot there by Terran Frey, and he takes his total now to 41. So it definitely got what it deserved. Burgess bowled down on his pads a bit too close and a bit too full, and it got what it deserved. Somerset now 110. Somerset now have moved to 110 for three. Burgess goes back to his mark. Terran Frey now on strike. Burgess to Frey. Cuts this one. Beautiful shot. Another classical shot by Terran Frey. Beautiful. He went back. Square cut this. Backward, just backward a point. And goes all races to the boundary. And all Alec Douglas could do is just stand and watch. Two shots back to back by Terran Frey. Two classical shots. Off the back foot, square cut all the way to the boundary. Terran Frey right now is in his groove. 45. Burgess, last delivery of this over. Right arm over the wicket to Frey. Frey, a loud appeal. And Kane's not interested. Frey looking to get forward. Bat pad. And that is the end of the over. Somerset now 114 for three. Terran Frey now on 45. Quickly got on to 45 as well as he hit a six. And right after he hit a four, he hit a six into the square leg. And then hit a four. You're listening to Cup Match 2023 with the voice of Summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.7.
This year, Cup Match, the most anticipated public event on Bermuda's calendars, will start with the much-loved namesake cricket match at St. George's Cricket Club commencing the morning of the 3rd of August. This two-day phenomenon is only one facet of the jewel that is Cup Match, known by history-savvy Bermudians as Emancipation Day, followed by Mary Prince Day. Nowadays, Cup Match presents a cornucopia of activities inspired by our beautiful summer surroundings. We'll pursue the new and exciting features, always allowing for a moment of reflection along the way. Lindo's, why go anyplace else?
Did you know that you can book your doctor's appointments online? Moongate Medical, Bermuda's newest general practice, makes it simple and easy to schedule your physicians right from where you are, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For general checkups, TCD appointments, sick notes, and prescription advice, we are here for you. Do you need an exceptional, compassionate, and trustworthy physician? Dr. Karen Fedlin and Dr. Andrea Guilford can accept your appointment today. Call 295-4265 or save time and book online at moongatemedical.bm. Moongate Medical, better health for a better quality of life.
Calling all Apple users.
We have huge news, from iPhones to MacBooks, Apple Watches to iPads, and more. One Communications is your one-stop shop for Apple products. But that's not all. New and existing One Communications customers are eligible for big savings with up to $2,500 off new devices. Shop online at onecom.bm or visit us in-store today.
I want to say a special thank you and good afternoon to all the wonderful people at One Communications. They have made this broadcast possible in ways you just could not imagine. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Happy Cup Match. Colby Fox, Shira Jatto, all the wonderful people there. Thank you. It's my cousin.
Yeah, my man, Seward. I was out there yesterday in the rain.
Yes.
You always doing some testing.
Yes. Thank you, Colby. Thank you, Seward. Thank you, everybody. It's Rodney Trott bowling from the eastern end, directly below our sports microphone, bowling his ninth over. 114 for three is the score here at Wellington Oval. 114 for three. Dion Stubble has seven. He's taking strike from Rodney Trott. Trott spins this one up to Stubble, who pushes it back down the wicket. It's overcast here, but just nice and cool and very comfortable.
What? What
nice
word to you?
Comfortable.
Okay, that's about a word.
Very comfortable.
That four-letter word is not appropriate right
cool.
now.
Trott to Stubble. Stubble skips down the wicket and plays this one out to Rollins at mid-wicket.
Sean, so just as I go into water break, during the Cup Match selection show, we had spoke about the selections of the team and what ideas or strategies St. George would think about picking a heavy spin attack. I said, well, remember, Dion Stubble, Taryn, and even Jordan De Silva, some of the best batters of spin bowling on the island.
Yeah.
So be careful, because Jordan, he's one of the best sweepers. He gets out on that front foot, and he's, for some reason, he could paddle. He likes to sweep. But Dion and Trey Mendes also, as you know, Dean, the key to batting spin is moving your feet.
That's right.
Picking up the pitch of the ball, the speed of the ball, and getting to the pitch of the ball.
That's right.
And Dion, you see him, watch him. He moves around a bit, and he moves, and he gets right behind it.
That's right.
I can say this. Standing from behind the stumps, when I see a batsman that is afraid to leave the crease,
oh, you got it.
Then I know there's hesitation.
Yeah.
But when you see a batsman like Dion and some of these guys not afraid to leave the crease, and you have a good keeper behind, that basically means they bat with confidence against spin.
That's right. Yeah.
So you can't, as spin bowling, you cannot be afraid to leave the crease.
That's right.
You got to leave the crease.
That's right.
And you will see with Dion, will look to leave the crease to get to the pitch. Now, if you have that confidence, then it's nothing that you can actually go ahead and do.
That's right.
In your playing days, especially when you had the likes of Maxwell Curtis, Chick Adams, and even Calabash, who were some of the batsmen that really... Because you guys really had a good spin attack. Who really looked comfortable?
Yeah,
but
I guess, you know,
Thomas aside.
I guess at that time, I mean, you had guys like Jeff Richardson. He was one that could actually, he didn't have a problem with playing spin. Albert Steed was definitely one, he didn't have a problem playing spin. I mean, he would do unorthodox shots, but
right.
He didn't, you know, he just didn't have a problem. You know, so you had a few of them, like Dexter Basin and a few of these guys that just didn't have a problem in playing spin. Another one was Gennaro Tucker.
Yeah.
Of course, when I played against Gennaro, they didn't have a problem, right? They will go and smother the ball. So there was a technique to get in line, to just get behind the ball. So if you do miss it, it sort of hits your body. So these guys were very good at that technique of picking the line, knowing how much turn is going to go ahead and turn, and then getting in line so it doesn't come through to me, right? So they were very good at their technique and seeing it early, because that's one of the things. If you don't see it early,
yeah,
then what happens? You have a tendency to play spin off. You will play spin off the wicket. You're not supposed to play spin off the wicket. you have to see it from the bullet's end, sir. Yeah.
And it's something that not just in Bermuda, but the West Indies is struggling with.
Yes. Yes.
I believe it played a major role in the England in the Ashes, the England tying up, drawing the Ashes, but they won the Ashes to retain the Ashes. But after Lions went out.
Yes.
Around the world, spin attack has been dominating the game of cricket. And we're going to see more of that, especially at the end of the year when we, or the end of the summer, when we have to play qualify for the World Cup, when we have to face teams like Canada.
Yes.
We know they'll be.
They love spin. They love spin. They were brought up on it. Yeah. And that's one of the things that we have to now embrace, because now, as you already know, many of the teams will introduce spin. And actually, you've got wrist spin, you've got finger spin, but also the pace of the spin has changed. You know, you're not going to see a David Adams anymore.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to see a David Adams where he will flight it. That's not going to happen. These guys, our medium pacers, are what you will see spinners doing. So you talk, you know what I mean? You got someone that bowls. I mean, I could only look at Brian Hall. Now, Brian Hall, as coming up right now, he will bowl at a pace, but that will be a spinner's pace.
Yes.
You know, internationally.
It's crazy you say that, because last week Sunday, I did the Aventis Cup match down in Shelly Bay Field. And one of the players who played was Richardson.
Yes.
From Cleveland.
Yes.
Johnny.
Yes.
Johnny Richardson.
Yeah.
And I was thinking the ball was slipping out of his head because he's flighting it way up above. Yeah. And then it dropped down.
Yeah.
I was looking like you see somebody slow pitch softball, right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, hold on. That's a stock ball.
That's right.
That's a stock ball, sir. Okay.
Kid, and the thing is that the game has evolved so much that the batting skill of players, the minute that you give it flight, even sort of pace builders, they walk down to them, right?
Yeah.
But if you give it flight, they're chasing and they're going to hit.
Yeah.
You know, so they'll give a baseball shot just like that. You know, so yeah, it has evolved. It has evolved big time. Yeah.
Just like we're seeing in St. George's innings, we will see some spinners, especially in Somerset's team with the likes of Dag Bregman, Dion Stubble.
That's right.
You know?
So now we have Brian Hall. He's going to be taking it from the Western end. Ball to Frey. Frey drives this one, or drives it to the short middle infielder. It's going to be Delray Rollins to field it. Here comes Hall again to Frey. Frey sweeps this one, handsomely sweeps this one. Actually, paddles this one, going behind the stumps. Down to the fine leg boundary. It's going to be picked up by Zende Farbit, and they go through for three. Good running between the wickets there by Dion Stubble and also Terrence Frey. And they will run between the wicket very quickly.
Oh, he's calling.
It looks like Terrence Frey is actually calling for medical assistance.
I think he's got cramp.
I think it's a bit of hamstring.
He's got cramp.
Yeah, it's hamstring.
Yeah.
I think you know that when Dion Stubble comes to the wicket, you better run. from playing with him, seeing him, and then playing internationally, he actually runs between the wickets. He's very aggressive in his running between the wickets. So we see Terrence Frey getting a bit of assistance, stretching it out. So they go through for three. Score now, Somerset, 117 for the loss of three.
I'm going to say thank you to the Richardsons over there.
Yes, thank you.
Andrew and Bissy. More busy because I know Andrew didn't have anything to do with these cookies.
Bissy, we love you, Bissy. Love you. I will say
cousin. Here comes Hall. And Frey looking to drive it. Not much power behind it, but it hits it straight back to Brian Hall. Just on the right hand side of the umpire canes. Here it comes. Oh, full pitch. It's going to the mid-wicket boundary, and it goes. Looks to be six runs. Uh-huh. Six runs. Oh, lets this one out of his hands. Full toss. And it got what it deserved. And now Terrence Frey quickly moves to
48. Terrence Frey is now on. Sorry, I stand corrected. That is Deion Stubble. Deion Stubble has hit this one for six. And he goes to 12. Hole to Stubble. Stubble well forward. Summits at 123 for three. Hole. Stubble. Stubble again. Forward defense. Plays it back down the wicket and is collected by Hole. And that is the end of the over. As we see, with I got messed up there, Jason, because you look at Taryn and you look at Deion, same height.
Yes.
Same hat.
Yes.
So I got. Oh, cousin.
Oh.
Oh no, see,
yeah, but put these boys to sleep.
Oh, all I need is coffee now.
Put these boys to sleep.
Now we see it looks as though Delray Rollins is gonna be coming back on from the eastern end. So St. George has now have decided to use two spinners. One from the western end and now one from the eastern end. So Delray Rollins, he's going to return back to his duties of bowling.
That's all they really have, other than Zico Bridges. It's all spinners, eh?
It is all spinners. And I'm a bit surprised that they haven't used Alan Douglas as yet.
But also, I'm surprised Benias hasn't taken the ball to see what's out there. Just a little cutters here and there. Longer tread will give us Emma Kai Simmons. They have some actual some other bowling options just to see what the wicket do. Get some cutters in there. Right?
Very interesting. Okay. Rollins into Frey. Frey well forward. Forward defense.
I think it'd be important to keep mixing up their bowling to give these batsmen something different to look at, right?
That's right. Rollins again hits this one, goes out to point where it's there by Brian Hole. This one was way with wide. And Terrence Frey now goes on to 49. Terrence Frey is now on 49. This one was wide and looked to cut it, which brings Deion Stubble on strike. He's got 12. Summers at 124 for three. Rollins is going to be bowling to Stubble. Stubble doing some maintenance of the wicket, petting it down. Bit of gardening. Here comes Rollins. This one is short. And Stubble looking to square cut, but he didn't get. Just comes off his glove and goes straight down in front of him. Rollins to Stubble. This one again is wide outside the off stump and Stubble looking and reaching it. Cuts this one to Brian Hall's feeding at point. Rollins is struggling a bit. Not able to find his good line and length. This one is full and it's driven straight down to the middle of area where you see Charles Trott. No chance of a run. So Rollins is into his last ball of the over. He stops. Again, adjusting his run up. He's going to be bowling to Stubble. Stubble again looking to square cut, but he just lets it go through to the wicket-keep. Smith, who's loved it really neatly behind the stumps. He's had a good session behind the stumps. So you're listening to Cup Match 2023 with the voice of Summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.7.
Take some advice from your Aunt Angie. If you're going to invest in an exotic pet, choose anything but a Norwegian forest cat. Apparently, they will eat all your jewelry. Before you know it, you're racing to the vet when your cat escapes from his carrier and lunges for your earrings. You crash, and your cat swallows your pearls. But if you're smart, you'll have CG Motor Insurance and get the best comprehensive coverage for the price.
Get the best comprehensive coverage for the price. CG Insurance. Good like that. All benefits are subject to policy provisions, including eligibility at the time of service.
124 for three at here at Wellington Oval. It's Brian Hall is going to continue bowling from the western end. This will be Hall's second over. His first over, he gave up 9 runs, and he's going to be bowling to Terran Frey, who has 49. Terran Frey's on 49. He'll be taking strike as Brian Hall comes in right arm over the wicket. He bowls, and Frey gets an outside edge. This one goes down towards the third man boundary, and that's his half century. That's his 50. He moves on to 51. 51 for Terran Frey. And he's going to be congratulated in typical cup match fashion. 51 for this young man. And a well-batted 51 indeed. We hear the ear horns. We see the crowds coming out onto the field to congratulate him. 51, his 50 coming in 86 deliveries. 136 minutes, 4 fours, and 1 6. 50 for Terran Frey. And we see him being celebrated in typical cup match fashion. We're joined by the Deputy Governor, Mr. Tom Oppenheim. Have you seen this anywhere else in the world?
I confess I have not.
You have not.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Happy cup match to you.
Happy cup match. Happy
Welcome to Wellington. Happy Emancipation Day. You've seen cricket all over the world, haven't you?
I have. I've been very fortunate to watch cricket in lots of places.
Yeah.
And I have never seen anything like this. So I confess this is a unique combination of cricket and culture and carnival and party. And
is it wonderful?
It's great. It's absolutely fantastic.
This is your what? Second? Third cup match?
This is my second cup match.
Second cup match.
So my first is St. George's.
Yeah. So what I won't even put you on the spot to actually compare, but it's to compare the venues, yeah. But it's just the event itself.
I don't mind comparing. This kind of feels smaller and tighter and a little bit more like a Roman Colosseum.
Yeah,
strolling out to face the Lions, it gives a great atmosphere. There's a lovely atmosphere at Somerset too, of course. But
absolutely beautiful. So, Terran's 50 coming in 86 minutes, and so the game. So all along, of course, because Somerset have had the cup for the last several years, St. George come in as the underdogs, but we always say that the game is played on the field. So you can come in as an underdog. Despite that, the game is played on the field, and it doesn't make a difference.
The underdog is, there's always one, isn't there, in a two-sided contest.
That's right.
Someone who's a favourite. I think, I would imagine that 12 years of pain have some sort of impact on the people who are playing because they're similar sets of players.
That's right.
And I suspect it means that for St. George's it's very important that they don't get punnelled in the first innings, that they get on top and feel that they're in the game quickly. I thought they did that well in the first sort of 40 minutes, and then Somerset fought back well. They've moved the scoreboard along, they haven't got stuck at any points, and with two set batsmen now, this looks like a big ask. I wonder if they brought on Brian Hall maybe to buy a wicket a little bit, tempt the batsmen to go after him. They were playing trot with great care and patience whilst he was bowling a very tight line, finding some good lengths.
Right, you sounded like an analyst there. Yeah. Well done.
I've been paying attention to the first session. That's easier to do.
That's right.
Higher as the day goes on.
That's right. So you're here all day for 2 days?
I'll be off here pretty much all day today. We've got some guests from overseas visiting, so we'll see about tomorrow.
Are they here today?
Yes.
So what are their thoughts?
They are having a fabulous time.
That's what we like to hear. There's really nothing better than cup match, especially for us. This is my Christmas. I look forward to this every year, and this is just the best time of year. Nothing more enjoyable. Brings Bermudians together, people from all walks of life, whether you like cricket or not.
Just bounced in front of Slip, I think.
Yep. No, he's very lucky. Very lucky. Terran Frey on 51 and got an edge, and then just one bounce did Rodney Croft down at first slip.
You have to reset.
after
that's right. Time. So it always provides a bit of a distraction and loses his concentration.
Yeah, it can help to have a little close call just after that to give yourself a little shock and wake up the system a little bit.
That's right. That's right.
Scratching away at his guard.
That's right. Brian Hall bowling with one man in the slips, then there's a silly mid on. This one he watches go by and it cuts back late.
He's giving some air, isn't he?
Yeah.
Floating the ball up there.
Yeah. He's had a good season, Brian Hall. He's claimed the most wickets in the league. Yeah. Right arm over again. Call to Frey. Frey's forward. He's wrapped on the pair. There's a lot of peel from Hall. But Mr. Kane says not out. That's the end of the over. 31 overs have been bowled. It's 126 for three. In 31 overs, Dion Stubble is on 12. Terran Frey, 51. Brian Hall's bowled 2 overs, giving up 11 runs. Delray Rollins, 8 overs, 1 for 41. Average of 5.1 runs per over. A bit expensive. He was having difficulty with his line and length in the beginning.
Do you think that was great with the ball? With a newer ball?
Right. Well, and you're a spinner and you're opening up. That's what happens, yes? And so he had that show. Now the ball is a bit older, a bit more worn, and so maybe he'll have a bit more. It'll be a bit easier for to get some practice.
He bowls with some great energy. He puts a lot of pivot as he moves through his action there.
Big things expected from him in this match.
Turn and bounce.
That's right. Rollins again. Left arm around the wicket. Gives this one a bit of air. And Stubble stands up and punches it out to deep extra cover. Fielded out there by Jeff Bridges out there in the country. And they go through for a comfortable single.
Just finding that length has been a bit of a challenge for him consistently. And when he's found it, he's looked very dangerous. He's able to spin the ball significantly.
Yeah. Left arm around, Rollins again. And this one's wide outside the off stump. And he watches that one go by. Terran Frey. Frey pushes that one out into the covers again. And it's Burgess who fields, returns it to the wicketkeeper, Smith. They go through for a comfortable single. Terran Frey moves on to 52. And Somerset are 128 for three. 128 for three in 31.3 overs. Good ball. Cut back sharply.
That's his version of the arm ball, I guess.
Yeah. That's right. Rollins again. Left down the line. Quicker one. And Stowe spotted it and pushed it forward. Back down the wicket. No run. One ball to go in this over. Threatening clouds that we saw a minute ago have gone away. And a shorter delivery, and Stubble stands up and pulls it from outside the off stump around through mid-wicket. They go through for a comfortable single. Stubble moves on to 14. Somerset move on to 129 for three. And that's the end. No, one ball to go. There's a no ball. That's right. Gets an outside edge, and it goes through to the left of the slips fieldsman, and they managed to go through quickly for two. Rodney Trott wasn't able to get a hand to it in the slips, and so it goes down towards the third man. Brian Hall runs down and fields, and they managed to go through successfully for two. And so that's two more to...
You know, Sean, I was just looking at Delray, and I was thinking, I'm wondering if he has the Chinaman in his arsenal.
Yeah.
I'm wondering, wondering, because he probably does, but he hasn't used it yet.
He hasn't used it yet.
Yeah. So, it'll be interesting.
Now might be the moment, mightn't it?
It could be the moment right now.
Yeah, that's a couple of chances. One opportunity a little while ago, and that sort of potential catch through between the keeper and set.
The end of the over. 32 overs have been bowled. 131 for three. Those are all the sort of things that he would have picked up during his time in Sussex with the direction and curling coaching rolling coaching that he would have received over there.
Of course.
But in saying that, he's been playing his cricket down at Bailey's Bay.
That's right, with Gus Logie.
And Taryn Frey.
That's right. That's right.
I'm pretty sure Taryn knows what's in his basket.
Takes a mighty swing.
Top edge time.
Gets a top edge. Goes over the head of the slip fieldman. Trot down toward the third man area where it's fielded down here by
Douglas.
Alan Douglas Jr. They get a single.
I just have the feeling of a game that is about to have something happen, doesn't it?
Yeah. That anticipation. Yeah.
We've got 10 minutes before lunch, is it?
15. So lunch 15? Is at 12:50.
Oh, right. Okay.
Another 15 minutes.
This is the period right here.
Brian Hall to Stovall. Turns this one around the corner. The backward of square. It's being chased and picked up out there by
Azende
Frebert. They get two. Stovall moves on to 18. Somerset march on to 135 for three. Brian Hall again. Going right arm move the wicket. One man in the slips. Backward gully. Two men in the covers. A man on the cover point boundary. Mid off. Short mid wicket. Stovall turns this one on the onside. No addition to the score there. Hall and Stovall, a late glance, gently touches that one and pushes it down toward the third man. They go through for two quite comfortably. Dion Stovall goes on to 20. And Somerset move on to 137 for three. One ball to go in this over. Brian Hall again. And Stovall just dabs that one again down toward the third man area. And again, they go through for two. Have to hustle for the second one that time. But they managed to go through instead, nevertheless.
I detect that that Stovall is more keen on those second runs than Frey is at this point.
Yes, that's right. That's right. That's right.
Feeling the heat a bit.
You can see the difference. That's right.
It's interesting. He's obviously looking to play Hall from the crease. Whenever there's any length to play with, he's coming back and looking to late cut him or nudge it away on the leg side if it's a little bit straight. And they're not biting on the bait of the floaty one outside off stump. No one's trying to drive straight or go over the infield for the time being.
That's right.
Very circumspect.
That's right. Well, that's the end of the over. 139 for three, 33 overs. Dion Stovall on 22, Taryn Frey on 54. You're listening to Cup Match 2023, live from Wellington Oval with the voice of summer on Magic 102.7 and Hot 107.5.
We know life can be unpredictable, like the outcome of a cricket match. But at Bermuda Motors, our team is united by a shared passion for cars and an even greater passion for making your dreams come true. That's because your happiness and satisfaction are our ultimate rewards. Bermuda Motors, with the power of care, drives us to serve you better.
This cup match, try the new Bacardi Mojito ready-to-drink can at the game, at the beach, or at home. Crave it wherever you go. Bacardi, do what moves you. Love Cup Match? Drink responsibly. Available across the island at the Burroughs Life Point stores, 127 Front Street, City of Hamilton, and 30 Harbor Road, Paget. And now available on Quanto. Download the app for more information.
And welcome back to Wellington Oval. We're inside the 34th over. Scores 139 for three. Rollins continuing from the eastern end, bowling two. Taryn Frey, he's on 54. Frey's driving in that handsome drive.
Lovely.
Actually, that's a beautiful
stroke.
Shot.
Oh, my goodness. Not a bad move.
That is the one of the most prettiest shots in cricket.
The cover drive, the classic stroke in cricket.
Taryn Frey moves on to 58 now.
58 with Taryn Frey. And Dean, when this over finishes, we're going to go through some names with Taryn who has overtaken the most runs in cup match.
Umpire is asking them to stop the music. One of the rules is that you cannot have music playing while the game is going on.
Try to let your slide while you're playing. You gotta stop.
That's a fundamental rule of this game.
Yeah. Rollins to Frey in defense. You normally see that on the second day when the umpires are pleading.
Yes.
That one's overpitched again. That's four more. Four more as Rollins is overpitched. And Frey opens up the blade and beats the man at backward point. Races to the boundary for four runs. So he's now on 62. 147 for three after 34 overs. And I said he's on 63, 62, actually. So he came into the match with 519. Plus, there you go, 62. So right now he is on 581. So he came into the match sitting at 31st. Dean, he has passed Lee Rayner, Warren Simmons, Lloyd Simmons, Fred Darrell, Andre Doc Mendes, Joseph Bailey, and Richard Bailey, and Dexter Bailey. In his one innings. So he's made his way all the way up to 24th place. You might know this person who's in front of him, sitting on 607 runs, Lionel Thomas. He's putting himself in a
in a great category.
Mm?
Great category, I tell you. Yeah, legends.
Above Lionel Thomas,
yeah.
Alex Cocky Steed, the late Glenn Blakeney. Calvin Bummy Simons.
Wow. Just to sit amongst them. That's amazing.
Yeah. Deion Stubble, fourth defense to Brian Hall. Hall's in his fourth over. He's given up 19 runs so far. This one at the back of the hand. Quicker. Stubble spots it. Gets behind it. 147 for three. Time a little bit more here. Plays it on the onside. We haven't said good morning to our chief statistician today, Mr. Thomas Ball. Yeah. Shout out to Lorenzo Tucker, who's bailed out on his tuck. No. Well, no, he's in the back room staff for St. George's, but he bailed out on us.
Yeah, Burley coach.
Burley coach, yes.
Yeah.
That's something.
But we have Mr. Thomas Ball. And folks, if you want our home, you can go to his website, TNT Scores. You can see the score as live, as we see.
Live as it happens.
Yeah.
That's right.
Chat to Chantel. She was with us last year.
Yes.
Hall now is burning around the wicket from the western end to Stubble. Just changing some angles. Double punches this out to the mid off. Misfielded there by Burgess, but they didn't run the first one hard. So 35 overs now have been completed. 148 for three. 148 for three. 148 for three. Hall has bowled four overs. No maintenance, none for 20. Delroy Rollins, 10 overs. No maintenance, one for 54. It looks like it's going to be, let's see, will it be the captain or Allen Douglas?
You know, Jason, when we were talking about Taryn Frey going up in the averages.
Yes.
You know,
most
when
runs.
You look at with the most runs,
yeah.
When you look at players like that and you smile because you start to see that they get it.
Yeah.
You know, they understand cup match. They understand the excitement and how to control, sort of how to compose himself, you know, in these situations. He came through when everyone else was falling around him, and he decided, I'm just going to stay with him myself, and I just, you know, he gets it.
But that's a true opener, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That's a true opener.
That's what you need.
Yeah. And it's been interesting because over the last few years, he's almost had to change his style because of the shorter version of the game. He excels in this form of the game more than anything, right?
Definitely. Well, this is his form of the game. He's already admitted it and saying T20 is not really me.
Yeah.
50 overs, yeah, I could do it. But the longer version, he's already openly stated it, that he enjoys this. He loves to build an innings. You know.
It's going
to
be Allen Douglas from the Eastern End.
6 bowlers they've employed. Yeah, just looking down the list, 6 bowlers.
Trying to break another partnership. This partnership is worth 54. This ball's beaten. Frey outside. Actually, stubble. That's a bye. Beat the batsman and wicketkeeper. If he gets it right, he could be quite dangerous on this wicket. Pitched up. Frey playing on the inside. Get one. One fifty up for Somerset. 150 for 3 after 35.2 overs. Coming in 158 minutes. So 150 for Somerset. Allen Douglas. To Stubbles, driven straight back at Frey. Frey had to get out of the way. As Simmons chases it down, but they go through for at least 2. And looking to get 3 here. So some good running there. Oh, there's going to be more. There's going to be overthrow.
That's 4 runs.
So 3 plus 4. We can do the math on this one. That's 7 runs. We don't see that often. But that's how you get 7 runs. Not 6 runs. 7 runs. In cricket, they ran 3, and then there's an overthrow that went to the boundary. Hey, guess what? It all goes to the batsman too.
Thanks, Doug. That's what I can see. I can see Taryn Knowles. Thanks, Doug.
He's now on 63.
Yeah.
157 now for 3.
Trying to get Zico, he was trying to get Zico Bridges' attention. He was like,
he's got him now. Zico's out on midwicket. No, actually, on the cover boundary.
Yeah. Extra cover boundary.
Taryn Frey, 163. This one spins into Frey as he pushes out to point. Umpire seeing 2 more balls. Or legal balls, you should say.
Mm-hmm.
There could be no balls. Douglas, a quicker one. Frey just tucks it on the one side, back with a square. They strike through for 1. So 1 more for Frey. He's on 64. Allen Douglas, Deion Stubble. Deion Stubble gets behind, look to work it on the one side, taken down the leg side by Smith. And that's the end of the 36th over. So the score is 158 for 3 at Wellington Oval. This is the 121st edition of the Classic Cup Match 2023 with the Voice of Summer on Hot 107.5 and Magic 102.7.
Calling all Apple users.
We have huge news from iPhones to MacBooks, Apple Watches to iPads, and more. One Communications is your one-stop shop for Apple products. But that's not all. New and existing One Communications customers are eligible for big savings with up to $2,500 off new devices. Shop online at onecom.bm or visit us in-store today.
Are you tired of juggling your finances? Need an extra hand keeping track of your cash flow? Introducing Guardsman, your ultimate cash management solution.
With Guardsman, say goodbye to financial stress and hello to financial freedom.
Imagine never having to stand in line to make deposits again. Guardsman provides you with a secure and convenient way to protect your hard-earned cash.
You can rest easy knowing our highly trained security officers and specialists are always on duty, protecting your best interest.
Guardsman, the Caribbean's largest cash management and security technology solutions provider since 1977.
And servicing businesses island-wide in Bermuda for almost 4 years. So why wait? Sign up today and experience the ease and confidence that comes with smart cash management.
For more information, contact us on 296-9111 and follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Guardsman Bermuda. Choose safety.
Choose security.
Choose Guardsman.
Yeah, we've seen Tumas Field. So it's Somerset 161 for three. Deon Stubble, not one strike. He's got 30. And Taryn Frey, 167. Brian Hall now into his fifth ball. His fourth over. Stubble well forward. Forward defense. Trickles down to Delray Rowland, who's feeding short middle one. He's coming up now to the... Even closer. Oh, gives it a bit of flight, but that is the end of the over, yeah. And we are now at lunch.
Well, we had lunch. It's been a fantastic morning to play. Coming back, right? Well, later on, you can do it later on. Later on this afternoon. Well, it's been a fantastic morning. The weather has cooperated much better than we anticipated. Didn't expect this level of cooperation from the weather at all. It's been nice and cool
he keeps using the word comfortable. Cool,
I'm very comfortable.
He is cool.
I'm very comfortable.
Somebody told him it's cool, man.
I'm very comfortable.
Yes, it's been a wonderful day.
And thank we're very thankful for this for the weather that we've had. We're also thankful for the level of cricket that we've had. St. George won the toss and sent Somerset in to bat. The scorecard that we have seen so far today reads as follows. Somerset opened up with Chris Douglas and Taryn Frey. And the scorecard reads as follows. Chris Douglas was caught by the wicketkeeper Cynthia Smith off the bowling of Zico Burgess. For three, he faced 16 deliveries. He's there for 19 minutes. Taryn Frey has been there since the very beginning. He's batted for, 164 minutes. He's had 6 fours, 1 6. He's faced 107 deliveries, and he's not out on 67. Trey Manders batted for 24 minutes. He had 2 fours. He faced 12 balls. He was caught by Makai Simmons off the bowling of Delray Rollins for 9.
Out next in Bermuda brings the community together in celebration of Emancipation Day, the abolition of slavery in Bermuda, and Mary Prince Day. The Cup Match holiday represents the uniqueness of our island's people, clearly demonstrating that there's no place in the world quite like Bermuda. HSBC in Bermuda has been the lead sponsor for Cup Match since 2006, sponsoring live TV, radio, and online coverage for the event. HSBC is proud to be part of this important cultural celebration.
It's Cup Match!
That's right, little Utes. We're gonna experience Cup Match camping the Burmy way.
Daddy, did you bring the iPad?
What, man?
Uncle Teo, can I play with your Nintendo Switch?
Uncle Teo, you have games on your phone?
No. No iPads, no games, no Nintendo. This is camping.
We're all gonna be one with nature this weekend, right, Nana?
Who are you, Vi? You know I went straight to One Communications and got everything we needed for the holiday. Check my new TV. She's HD.
Nana!
Yay, Nana!
I bet my setup is way fancier than your Aunt Wallery's. Oh, this match is making my heart race now.
A generator? Nana, really?
Shoo, we're watching the game.
Go St. George's.
Uh-uh, Somerset.
St. George's.
Somerset.
Come back!